Fuying Bro here. One of the my subscribers made a really great comment that got me thinking. If an SS-15 stock buttstock, I don't have a SS-15 buttstock, but if I'm not mistaken, he's talking about the one that has a little guard that comes off the stock, so that you can bump fire. I believe that's what he's talking about. Anyway, if that would fit on the TAPCO for the SKS. And that got me thinking, well, they are both kind of the same kind of buffer tube. So yeah, I give it a try. So let me go ahead and show you. This is a TAPCO SKS. With a, I'm sorry, it's a Tula SKS, but anyway, it's a TAPCO intrafuge stock. Let's go ahead and take off. This buttstock. Take off the TAPCO buttstock. And as you can tell, the buffer tubes look really close, really similar, extremely similar. And I was like, wow, that's, yeah, that might work. So this is a commercial buffer tube with a commercial buttstock. So what do you know? It fits, but there is a tiny, tiny bit of wiggle. It does do the locking, just like all the other ones. Just a tiny, itty bitty little bit of a wiggle, if you can see there. So, yes, a commercial one will fit on there with a tiny bit of wiggle. But, for you that know about ARs, the mil-spec is a little bit smaller. I don't have a gauge to show the exact dimensions of the TAPCO tube that the that it rests on. If I can get this off. But a mil-spec one might work on there. But, so with that in mind, you can use a commercial style buttstock. So if you want to go ahead and if you have a SKS with a TAPCO system on it, the intrafuge stock system, you might be able to, well, you will be able to get a commercial buttstock to throw on there. That would fit with that wiggle. But you might be able to get a mil-spec one, and that might fit. But I'm not positive on that one. Now, I don't have a 1022 nor a 1022 stock, so I don't know if the 1022 version would work as well. So that's something to keep in mind for if you guys want to use AR stock butt for your TAPCO design stocks. Now back onto the SS 15 about using that on this type of stock. Yes, the well, I don't know how their buffer tube is, so it's probably a a commercial buffer tube design. So I honestly don't know. I've never had one. Never even used one. So I don't know if there will be a way to install a tube in here, but there might be. I mean, you do have two bolts to hold in there, but here's the big butt part of it. Where your little part on the SS-15 comes down so that you can bump fire. By the way, there are rounds in here, but there is nothing in the chamber. I just wanted to show you for how it is not even all the way on how it lines up on this next part. The problem is where this is in respect to here will give you an issue. Now, if you get one of those stocks and you want to make it just for this and not put it back over on your AR, I imagine you could cut your tube down and make it fit, but there's other lineup issues. So let me show you what I'm talking about with lining it up. So we got our buffer tubes lined up with our buttstocks, and here's the issue here is the trigger group, or actually just your trigger, lines up in a different area. It's almost into the magwell. In fact, if you line up a little bit more, it's halfway into the magwell, and your trigger's right up here and up. So the buttstock, unless you modified it, would not work. But that's not the whole thing to this video. The main part of the video is that you could put a regular commercial stock onto the Tapco stock, and it would work. So yeah, I hope you find this kind of interesting. I found it interesting. Now, honestly, there probably won't be another video for a little while. My wife has surgery tomorrow, and my family's coming in tonight for support. So yeah, this is probably the last one for a little bit. You guys all take care and stay safe, and have a good day.